You know, growing up in my household, in Karen Harris's house, college was not an option. It was a mandate. Okay, and my grandmother lived across the street. And in Claudette Harris's house, it was an edict. So for me, growing up in South Philadelphia, I knew I was going to college. Didn't know how I was going to afford it. Didn't know which one, but I knew what's going to happen. I knew it was going to happen because my grandmother was, she was married with three children. Her husband had left, and she was raising those three children in the 13th Street housing projects in Philadelphia. She was raising those children on her own, but she had determination, and she promised her children that they would have a better future than what she had. You see, Claudette's mother was a domestic worker. Claudette's grandmother was a domestic worker. Claudette's great-grandmother was a slave named Belle. But Claudette promised her children, my mother and my uncles, that they would have a good future. So Claudette, my grandmother, would go to work during the day as a teaching assistant in a daycare. After she would leave work, she went to Community College of Philadelphia, where she got her associate's degree in education. And I would pull out my wallet and show you her CCP ID. I carry it in my wallet every day as a reminder of the determination that my grandmother had. My grandmother left CCP after 2 years and went on to Temple University and got her bachelor's degree in education, all while raising her three children in the 13th Street housing projects in South Philadelphia. After graduating from Temple University, she went on and taught for 32 years in the Philadelphia School District, moving her children out of the housing projects onto a nice home on the 1400 block of 17th Street, where my mother, a graduate of Temple University, some years later, would buy a house directly across the street from my grandmother. That was my grandmother's promise to her children. She kept her promise that her children would have a better life. And it was because of her determination to keep that promise that my mother was able to get a college degree, and it changed the trajectory of our family for generations. I stand here with a degree from Millersville University, a master's degree from Cabrini College. I've started work towards a doctoral program. And all of that is because of the promise that my grandmother made. In 1963, there was a small gathering in Washington, D.C., led by Asa Philip Randolph and others. And there was a young speaker there by the name of Martin King. And at this small gathering, of course I'm being facetious, but at this gathering in D.C., Dr. King talked about another promise. He talked about the promissory note that was embedded in the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence. He talked about that promissory note, but he also talked about how America had defaulted on that promissory note insofar as its citizens of color were concerned. Dr. King talked about a check being marked insufficient funds, but he also talked about his belief that the Bank of Justice was not bankrupt. That same promise is embedded in our state constitution. Article 3, Section 14 of Pennsylvania's Constitution says that the General Assembly shall provide for and maintain and support a thorough and efficient system of public education to serve the needs of the Commonwealth. That same promise is embedded in our very state constitution. I stand here today as a co-sponsor, a co-prime sponsor of this bill because I believe the PA promise must be fulfilled. We've given a promise to our young people. We've said to them, if you go to school and you do well, you can go to college. But we're giving them a check marked insufficient funds because we aren't providing them with the resources to be able to be successful. So today, it is our responsibility as a legislature to fulfill the promise. Just like my grandmother fulfilled the promise to my mother and my mother fulfilled the promise to me, it is our responsibility as a Commonwealth to fulfill the promise that is guaranteed in our state's constitution. Many of our young people have these dreams of college education, but they can't fund the dream. And I submit to you that, as I close, there was a young poet who happened to graduate from one of our state related schools. He graduated from Lincoln University. His name was Langston Hughes. And the poet Langston Hughes talked about what happens to a dream deferred. He said, does it dry up like a raisin in the sun, or fester like a sore and then run? Does it stink like rotten meat, or crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags like a heavy load, or does it explode? And I submit to you today that many of our young people's dreams become deferred when they get their financial aid package. And although they've done well in high school, although they've held up their responsibility, their dream becomes deferred because they know that from that financial aid packet, they cannot afford college education. It is our responsibility to keep our word to Pennsylvania's young people. And the way you keep your word to them is by holding up our end of this Pennsylvania promise so that no more dreams go deferred in our Commonwealth with our young people.